All right, welcome back to the Fungeon. So, here we are. And, as per usual in the Fungeon, what we're going to do is get done with some of the specific things that we got to take care of. So there's a whole series of new assignments coming out today, and I will put up in just a moment. As soon as we're done here, I am going and I'm filming all of the assignments using screen record, and I will place them all on the website. But yesterday, I put I put up the I put up the assignments on Classroom, Google Classroom. Sorry, I'm thinking about like six things at the same time. So you already have them. They already came to you. If you're not sure, contact me. But all of the assignments I'm going to talk about in just a moment came through last night on Google Classroom. At least they should have. So I'm going to run right down through my classes. And then once we get through that, I'm going to talk about the art gallery announcement as far as our exhibition at Frontier. I'm going to talk a little bit about third quarter, fourth quarter grades, and reorganizing some of the website. So that's what we have going on so far. And then we'll talk about whatever we want to talk about. Okay, so painting class. Painting, you're going on another tour. Oh, that's nice. Going on a tour back to Paris. Do I have a sound effect for flying? Probably not. Here's a plane. No, not so much. Cats are having a problem upstairs. Okay, completing a tour of the Louvre painting class. So you are going to the Louvre website, and you're going to take one of the tours. There's a number of tours. I think there's at least four right away. And when I do the screen record, I'm going to go through it one step at a time, where I'm going to click and show you, and I'll narrate the whole thing saying, okay, here I am going here, and here I'm going here. You have to record five observations, type them out. I saw this, and I noticed this, and I saw this. So five things, and you're going to submit them in Google Classroom. So couldn't figure out how to do it. Okay, so Angela, well, let's just do it now. Why not? Hold that thought. Angela's here. Okay. So, Angela, let's just jump online with my handy dandy little, oh, now you know my password. Okay, that's for class later, so let me get a new thing up. Okay. So, for the Musée d'Orsay. So, Musée d'Orsay, the French. Okay. Okay. So Musée d'Orsay, I'll pull this up closer. And again, I'm going to go through this with a screen record eventually. But if I go to Musée d'Orsay and I go to their homepage, okay, it comes up and it has this big announcement that they're closed and all kinds of horrible things. And let's see, I gotta go to the full website. Sorry. Almost there. And I just gotta find it here. Buy tickets, collections. I'm just looking for the virtual tour. Prepare your visit, buy a ticket. It's a lot quicker right on the website that I gave you, so I'm struggling here for a second. Here, let's just try it this way. Let's try a virtual tour. Virtual tour. Yeah, the link is right there on the site, but I don't have it on my iPad. online resources. Let's say that's it. This might take more time than I want to do right now. What is museum? That's not it. Come on, man. There's that one site that I'm going to have to jump off of the computer to go find it. I'm going to have to come back to it, Angela. Hi, Jade. As soon as I'm done, this will be the first one I do. It'll just take me too long trying to stumble around with the iPad here. But as soon as we're done with this, the first thing I'm going to do is I'll do the painting one, and I will add to the Louvre tour, I will add the Musée d'Orsay review. And it's cold down in the Fungin today. I'll add that review on step-by-step how to do it. Okay? I promise. Okay. So, we'll get that up. Jade's here. Okay. There's more people. All right. So, 5 observations for painting on a virtual tour. And there's a couple of different ones to choose from, but... we'll have that in a bit. Photo to students. What you're doing is you're going to shoot 5 photos over the next couple weeks. And this is due, all this stuff is due the 24th of April. Okay, so I've kind of staggered it. So you have about 2 days to do each assignment. They're little. You got to go shoot a photo. That's it. But this has to do with the rule of thirds. Okay, and it'll be on that video that I post, and it'll give you examples. But basically, when you're looking at your composing space, okay, anytime you're composing space, what you're breaking it up into is like a grid, okay? A grid could be horizontal, could be vertical, and your phones, sometimes software on phones or cameras actually preset this for you. A little grid pops up, okay, and it helps you compose the space. Basically, what you should do is you should be looking for these points and dropping your interest somewhere on those points, okay? You don't want to put your face smack dab in the middle. It kind of looks like you're being processed at a police station, like a mugshot, you know? Put your subject in one of these corners, and I'll show you specific examples of this on the video for specific to photo 2. But come on now. Let's see if we can find this a little quicker than the other problem. Rule of thirds. Bam. Okay, there we go. That's what I'm talking about. So, here's a picture of a doggy, okay? And you see how it's divided up there? Okay, there's 9 little rectangles that make up that composition. They drop the dog's head right in that cross section. Okay, it just helps compose the space. And there are tons of examples of this. There's another one, let it focus. So there's that little scene, silhouette of a person, and they dropped her head right there on the little crosshairs to make up that rule of thirds. Okay, so lots and lots and lots of different examples. There's a little silhouette of a kid with a cape on. Okay, lots and lots of examples. So take a peek around before you go out and try to shoot some of this stuff. There's a bee. Why? Because. Wah, wah. Okay, so lots of different examples of rule of thirds out there. Look, lots. So you're going to shoot 5 photos. The subject is up to you. But excuse me, how you compose that space, that's up to me. So, rule of thirds, 5 photos, put them in your shared Google folder, and I'm going to repeat this part, because I'm messing around with my chair here. When you go to our shared folder and you see photo advanced photography or photo 2 or whatever it's called, inside that folder are individual folders for each of you that I've set up. So it actually says Angelone. Like Angela has her own folder in there. So if you would please put your stuff in your folder, just because when I go to do the grading on this, I'm going to open up. There's your folder. There's your photos. So last semester, I'm going to take a quick break from that. As far as grading, they're going with pass-fail based on what we were working on when we left, approximately. And so all of my grades are up to date. If you check in Parent Portal right now, I've actually submitted all of mine. So if you went and checked there and you found some kind of discrepancy or something that didn't seem right, you want to kind of talk to me now, okay? Because I already submitted all my stuff. There was some stuff, some information about, what do you call it? Let's try coffee and see if it works out. Incomplete, or, you know, we're waiting on work. I just submitted all my grades. I think there was one that I had incomplete because that student had contacted me. But they have some extension, but I'm not really worried about it unless a student contacts me directly and says that we have some kind of problem. Okay, so the grades that are coming up, I'm going to try to keep them fairly simple because we're not around each other all the time to check on this stuff or to clarify it, although you can check in with me anytime. But just to try to keep things simple, if you give me the work in the format, it passes, okay? If the work's not there, it's missing, all right? So, and I'm not sure exactly what their policy is. I don't think they know quite yet what the fourth quarter grading is going to be, but I'm going to keep it fairly simple that it's going to be, for right now, pass-fail, okay, as far as the things that we're working on. As we move along, we get more information, maybe that will change, okay? We're just going to keep fluid, like reeds in the wind or jellyfish. You could learn a lot from jellyfish. So, where was I? Okay, so that's painting, or photo 2. And as soon as we're done with this, that's what I'm filming next. Painting first. Okay, film production. So when we left, we were doing these interviews. You're trying to do these interviews for the future. And I got some of them. I didn't get some of them. So we've got some students passing, some students not. Not based on that, just what we left with. So I'm going to come back to that idea. And you're going to film a short interview, meaning like a minute. Okay. And you're going to answer the questions based on the current events in the quarantine, what's going on in the world. Because up until now, you know, we've never experienced anything like this, and hopefully we don't again. But you are at a point in your life where this is obviously going to change things for you and potentially your kids for years and years, okay, as far as the history of it, how things have changed in the world. So with that short interview, you're going to answer these questions. What are you doing? What concerns do you have? What do you think will happen when it's all over? How will the world change? So just that short little interview, you could set up your phone. You can have someone try to do different angles on you. You could hold the phone from different points as you answer the questions. But think about your lighting. Think about your angles. But for the most part, it's this short interview. Once you have it done, you don't even have to put you don't have to put filters or anything along those lines. It's straightforward video, okay? Hopefully good lighting. And put it in the shared folder, make sure it goes in your name, and see the website. And for clarification, and then again, I'll be here today, tomorrow, and Thursday to answer any questions as I put this stuff out there to clarify things. So that's the idea for the film. Studio and Media Arts too. We're continuing to work with those Go Art filters. If you've done them so far, you find that it's super easy. It's just sometimes there's a little bit of wait time because it has become a very popular app because a lot of it is free and it all works off of one algorithm, one artificial intelligence out there that's applying these filters to your work. So sometimes, you know, if it doesn't work right then, come back to it a little bit later. Be perseverant and keep clicking away until it runs through. But we're looking for five portraits, five photos of people that you're going to edit. And these are, it's not just busy work, folks. This stuff is supplemental to things that we would have been doing in class. And at the very beginning of the semester, I said, I wouldn't teach you anything that you couldn't make money doing. And in addition to that, we're building your portfolio. So this is all work that we're going to put in your portfolio once we return. If it's not this year, then in the fall, I would sit down with students and help you prepare portfolios. So five portraits that are affected using the filters. So you're going to send me five portraits with five filters, one for each portrait, and put them in our Google Shared folder. Make sure put it under your name, okay? So under Flint, okay? And lastly, comic illustration. So for you guys, we're not done with drawing, but at this point in the course, we would not be in the 108 in the drawing studio anymore. We would be down in 307 and we would be working with the storyboard software. Well, I don't have that storyboard software, you know, I don't have it access to you at home, but I want to continue on with the class. So I purchased a license for software that's called Storyboard That. Okay. It looks like this, and the link will be on the website. But Storyboard That, and in purchasing the license, I purchased 25 seats, meaning one for everybody in the class that you can use this, and we can all use the software. Okay. What it does, let's see, create a storyboard, and this isn't going to show too well on the screen here, but that's why I'm going to do a screen record after this. But I just figured I'd show you really quick. So in the beginning here, yeah, we don't need to go through the whole thing. Okay. In the beginning, you're just going to use your preset artwork, the preset stuff. So here I can drag in a background. And then here, I'm going to click on characters. Dude, come on now. This is why we do screen record. Okay. And trying to do it upside down is a pain too. All right, hold on. They want me to go through the whole tutorial. Okay. Now I think we got it. So here are your panels in a comic. And what they have is they have preset buildings or backgrounds or forests or and you can customize them too, and it's really just a matter of like kind of playing around seeing what's possible. I'm going to click on characters up here. My giant sausage fingers are pushing the wrong keys upside down. There. Okay, so there's a scene, and I can actually drag people into it, and I can change
their color and their clothing and their actions and their pose. And so in this first assignment, just getting used to the software, you're going to make up little scenes. Okay. Eventually, you know, shoot down the road about 3 weeks, we're going to go from just using the stuff that they have set up to being able to photograph your drawings and import them and use that. Welcome to Caitlin. Okay, so that's comic, folks. And all of this stuff I'm going to break down with a screen record, because it's a lot easier than, or for you to follow and me to actually teach it if I'm not looking into a little camera and trying to do this upside down. So the comic book illustration, folks, for handing that stuff in, I'll show you how to save it and submit it. I think we can submit it right through the software. I don't know if we're even going to have to use the Google shared folder for this. I think it's part of the software, but I got to check that. I've been learning it too. But it's pretty cool. I think I only had to pay $20 for the month, and it gives us as a class access to all of it, so it's kind of cool. All right, so that's the rundown of the class work for the next probably 2 weeks or so, as we check in with one another. Let me just check my to-do list here. All right, so we did that in the Fungin. I'm going to do the screenshot videos as soon as we depart from one another. The art gallery. Art gallery. So if you would like artwork in the online Frontier gallery, send it to me. Send me work that you've been doing. Send me work that you've done at home. Okay, and I'll post it. And there was a question, you know, can we send more than one piece? Seniors, send me more than one piece. Other students, freshmen, sophomore, juniors, you can send me more than one, and I will definitely try to put all of them in. I can't make any guarantees right now because I've got to see first how many I get. If I get, you know, between kindergarten and high school, if I get 2,000 pieces of artwork, probably not putting them all of them in, okay? If I get 100, I can do that. I can put in 100 pieces and lay them out on the program, and that's, you know, easy peasy, lemon squeezy. But seniors, whatever you send me, I will put on your special site. The actual website will be listed by Thursday on my site, and I'll see if I can set it onto the district site as well. So this is, I don't know, something the art department is trying to put in place. If we don't have an art exhibit this year at the school, we're trying to piece together something where at least you're recognized for all the hard work you do. Grades I talked about earlier, as far as pass-fail for third quarter, not sure exactly what we're doing for fourth quarter, but we're just keeping on, keeping on. I'm going to reorganize the website a little bit tonight because, yeah, the dryer is right over there. Can you hear it? Okay. I'm going to reorganize the website because I'm going to take the things that have been on there as far as all the examples, and I'm going to move them to the specific class websites. And on that main page, I'm going to put all of the new screenshots of step-by-step how to do all this stuff. That is that. I think I covered everything. Does anybody have any questions about what's going on? I know I'm going to get to that specific question, Angela, as soon as I get done with this. I have you right here. And any other specific questions? Went camping, not last night, the night before. Got caught up in a show last night. It was really, really interesting. It is called I'm Not Okay With This. These comic books are crushing it. Comic book people, people don't even realize that there's so much of media out there right now on Amazon and on Netflix that all come from comic book origins. And most of the time people think of comic books just as Marvel characters and Spider-Man and Iron Man and DC characters, Batman and Superman. They think of maybe anime, but they don't realize that there's so many of the shows out there right now that don't even have superheroes in it, like Lock and Key is a comic book. Now, the one I'm watching, I finished the whole season. We sat down and watched it. My wife and I crushed it in, I don't know, a couple hours last night, called I'm Not Okay With This. It has superheroes, but it's more about, I don't know, being a teenager and things kind of sucking. So it's good. It's well worth your time. But a lot of great stories out there looking around. The Boys, that was funny, super inappropriate. Umbrella Academy, I can't say enough good things about that. Lock and Key was very good, but all of them, comic book stuff. So that is that. What else has been going on? I'm getting email. If you have, you know, as soon as we're done here, if you have specific questions and you didn't want it to come up on the screen or whatnot, you know, just email me right away. I'm really, as soon as we're done here, I'm walking upstairs. And out of the fun gin, I'm going to do another set of email. And then I am shooting each of these assignments, each class, their... I shouldn't have stayed up so late. We're going to shoot screen recordings of each of the assignments to show you how to do them and giving examples as well. I'm going to rebuild the website and then I'm going to start working on the art gallery, which I hope to post on Thursday. All right, so we're at the 28-minute mark. I'm going to stick around for about 3 more minutes here jabbering if you have any specific questions, and otherwise, we're going to sum this sucker up. Okay, I covered that. What do you think? How long are we going to be like this? I got a concert tonight. We're doing a concert on our porches, long distance. So one of my favorite bands from college, Lowest of the Low, Canadian band, awesome, look them up, Lowest of the Low. And the lead singer on Tuesday nights is doing a live broadcast from his apartment in Toronto. I think it's Toronto. And I just discovered it last week. So I went and contacted a bunch of my friends that are interested in that band that we used to go to see. And so this week we are hanging out on our porches. Should be good weather for tonight. And... watching the concert and then using Google Meet to hang out and chat with one another, even though we are in some cases states apart from one another. Go for about one more minute. Wearing my Media Arts Club Frontier t-shirt today. Proudly representing. Beer's getting thick. Jade's psyched that we're going back. If we go back on the 29th, that would be super. But we'll have to see how things shake out. I'm not sure. I have no information about it either way, but it still seems a little weird out there. But I'm ready to go back. I gotta get out of the fungin. Alright, folks, so we're gonna sum this up at the 32 minute marker. And I'm going to go in to start recording all this stuff in the recording studio. It's dusty down in the dungeon today.
Do you know what day, Aiden? Sorry, Aiden just got here and he's telling me about Linkin Park, who I really like. Yeah, let me know or email me, Aiden, when that show. I could look it up. Don't worry about it. I'd like to watch them or him. 32 is coming. Okay, so folks, if the waters don't rise, I will be back tomorrow. Same place, same back channel. And yeah, if you can't be good, be safe. Ba-dum-bum-ba-dum-bum.